Hey there, YouTube. I'm Rusty.
And I'm Bobby.
And today we are drinking Bulldog Root Beer.
That's right. Unleash the taste.
Yes. Unleash that taste in your mouth. Not other places.
Right.
Root beer appropriately belongs in the mouth.
And this is the original Bulldog, by the way.
Yeah, not to be confused with all those cheap imitations.
That's right.
Pakistani Bulldogs. Well, tell you what, Bulldog root beer may very well be my favorite root beer.
Yes, sir.
Now, you know, those place in my heart for IBC, Barks,
yeah,
all those root beers we love a lot. And, but man, Bulldog has really, they did a good job on nailing it.
Bulldog, and we talked about this a little earlier, Bulldog's in my top five. And part of the thing I like about Bulldog is they sweeten it with honey. And it's not a strong honey flavor, but it's a little bit different. You know, you can, and I think the difference is what makes it so good.
Well, if you're going to sweeten something, you need to do it with cane sugar, or you need to do it with honey.
Yes.
One of the two, or both. How about that?
Both.
Now, I remember the very first Bulldog root beer I drank.
Oh, really?
It was in Dallas, Texas. It was from a store on the south part of Dallas called Ifs, Ands, and Buts. And my old pastor and I, we knocked off at some conference we were at. And we drove like maniacs all the way across Dallas, made it to this little store.
Okay.
We bought some Bulldog root beers and some other root beer. I can't remember what else we got. But it was my first Bulldog root beer I ever had. It was ice cold right out of the cooler. And we drank it all the way back to the conference.
Mm-hmm.
Man, it was awesome. We got a speeding ticket. I was not driving.
Now, I've driven across Dallas before. You don't drive very fast when you go across Dallas.
We were on that one of those expressways where they clock you and send you a ticket in the mail.
Gotcha.
But I was not driving. But since then, I've drank a lot of Bulldog root beers, and they are great.
Yeah, they're
great.
Yeah.
And you don't want to confuse Bulldog with Mug.
Right.
Mug is a different root beer. I think. So who owns Mug? Pepsi?
I really don't know. It's one of those cola companies.
I think Pepsi owns Mug. Somebody look at we'll have our staff look at
that. That's right. We'll put it somewhere on the video.
Yeah. And I don't know. Whoever owns Mug, I like Mug.
Mug's good.
But it only comes in a can or a plastic bottle.
Mm-hmm.
What are you people thinking? Don't you have some money? Get, you know what we want? Let's get a lobby in Congress, man. We want Mug root beer and a glass bottle.
A glass bottle?
That's what we want.
Okay.
Okay. Put the Bulldog on it. But we want it in a glass bottle. We're going to review some Mug root beer eventually when we get down to it. We can't drink every root beer all at one time.
No.
Which we would love to.
But
you shouldn't do that.
It's hard enough to not drink the ones we have in the refrigerator between videos.
There are a lot of dog-themed root beers.
There are a lot of dogs, and we've done quite a few of them.
We did Dog and Suds.
Dog and Suds.
Three Dotsons.
Mm-hmm.
Here we got Bulldog. Then there's Mug that has a Bulldog on it.
Yeah.
It's also Margo's Bark.
Margo's Bark's got the dog. Of course, the cat's got a meow on the inside.
Yeah. On them. Out with the cats, man. Cats have nothing to do with root beer, okay? And then, what do they think?
That'd be like green tea. Would have a cat on it.
No, man. And then, you just get furry mouth when you think about cats and root beer. And then there's Sparky's. Sparky's is themed after a dog. There's a couple other dog ones out there, and I can't think of it right. Sea Dog. The Sea Dog root beer.
I don't think I've ever
heard that. I've had one, not lately, but we'll procure a couple of those. Anyway, this past week I was doing a little theological reading, and I was reading Anselm of Canterbury's argument about the existence of God. And his argument about the existence of God is really kind of semantical. I always thought that it was probably one of the worst ones I ever heard. And I believe in God.
Mm-hmm.
I just didn't think that was a good argument. He had holes all in it, logically. But then I read and I discovered that his argument for the existence of God was not actually an argument for the existence of God. It was a devotional thought about the existence of God. So it was taken out of context. Okay. And it's unfair to compare it with other arguments for the existence of God.
Right.
But then I got to thinking, you know, I was doing a lot of thinking about it. And I thought, you know, there is not a real argument for the existence of God in the Bible. Not in the Old Testament or in the New Testament. The Old Testament just simply begins, in the beginning, God.
Right.
It presupposes that you understand that there is a God. And I think, you know, there's a lot of debate on this topic, but I think that that is the intellectual default position for humans, is that there is a God. And I think you have to decide that there is not one to become an atheist.
Right.
Or an agnostic. You just have to doubt there is a God. But I think the basic position
is the starting place.
That there is a God.
Right.
You know, somebody, you can just, is a zebra white with black stripes, or is it black with white stripes? In the end, it doesn't matter, right? Well, if you choose not to believe in God, in the end, it doesn't matter. You just lose.
Yeah. Right.
All the way.
All the way.
And so, but I think the default position is that there is a God, and that we have to make some sort of decision or move towards Him. And fortunately, you get through reading the Old Testament, you get right on in the New Testament. Right. In the New Testament, we meet the second person of the Trinity, Jesus, the Son of God, and He is the avenue by which we come to know our Heavenly Father, our Creator, our God. What do you think about that, Bobby?
That's pretty good.
A lot of thankful for Country Boy from Elmer, Louisiana.
Drinking Bulldog.
Yeah. Drinking Bulldog root beers. Hey man, if you like Bulldog root beer, get on our, like us on YouTube. And if you're an atheist or an agnostic and you don't like us, then
that's fine.
Too bad for you. Stinks being you.
Yeah, we'll still get you a Bulldog. They're good. And I think you can find these. World Market is where I think we got these.
Yeah, these came from World Market down in Covington. We live in that part of Louisiana.
Right there.
In the toe of the boot.
Okay. Oh, well, I was like, where are they? Okay. Right there in the tongue of the boot.
Toe.
In the toe.
Toe of the boot, man.
What do you know?
Louisiana geography.
I don't wear boots. I was thinking the tongue of the shoe.
Anyway.
Somewhere in those little lace holes.
Get some boots, man. I'm Rusty.
I'm Buffy.
We'll catch you next time.